to sing about. We've got something to say. Because we're drawing from the wells of salvation with what?
Joy.
With joy, you need to memorize that verse. That's verse 3. With joy, and that day, you're going to draw from the wells of salvation. What do you need from the well? Go get it, honey. Go get it. Verse 5. Sing unto the Lord, for he has done excellent things. This is not on the earth.
Yes.
Has God been good to you?
Yes.
Has he been excellent to you?
Yes.
Can you improve on excellent?
No.
I think not. So you got the best of the creme. You got the creme de la creme.
Right.
You got the best of the best. You got the excellent. Not good, Tyrone, didn't that wonderful?
Yes.
Look at verse 6. Cry out. Look out. This is where Presbyterians and Lutherans and Baptists and Homeless, they have a problem with this verse. Cry out and shout. In church?
But we don't.
We do. Cry out and shout. Make a joyful noise to the Lord. What? Oh, there's that phonetic Belec again. I heard a definition of a fanatic one time. It's just somebody that loves Jesus more than you do. That's all. That's a fanatic. Just somebody that loves Jesus more than you do. What do you think the word fan came from? I'm going to give you another lesson here. Sidebar. You know what it says of sports fans? Well, how about that, sports fan? Did you see that? Strip of home run. Look here. Look at what. Did you see that, sports fan? Fan. Well, where do you think fan came from? Fanatic. No. Yeah. That's just a nice way to say fanatic. Well, the really refined and sophisticated way. He's a sports enthusiast. Well, call me fanatic or a Jesus enthusiast.
Yes.
Can we? I'll give you another lesson. What do you think the word enthusiast means? Break it down. Etymologically. All right, etymology of a word is breaking it down as to what it means and where it came from. The word enthusiast, 400 years ago, came into existence. And it was an accusative and not a complimentary term. It, because it's the same as being called fanatic. The preface of the word, en, means in or full, inside of you. Enthuse comes from the word theo in the Greek, which means God. So enthusiast means full of God. Would that all of us Christians be so accused of being, hey, you full of God, you?
Hey,
how many know you've been called full of something else, right? How many need you? How many would prefer to be called and accused? You're full of God, you. Well, go ahead and blame me. Come on, I'll buy that. Yeah. Accuse me, go ahead. Yeah, thank you. To be called a fanatic for Jesus is a compliment. To be called a Jesus enthusiast is also extremely complimentary. So in that day, cry out and shout. Why? Because you're supposed to know. But because you've got something to cry out, that is to declare. To shout, you got something to shout about.
Hallelujah.
No, yeah. You got something to shout about.
Amen.
In church? Well, if you can't do it in church, honey. This ought to be the place where you can have the greatest expression of drawing from the wells of salvation.
Yes.
This is it. If you can't rejoice in the Lord among your brothers, well, we need to have some level of sophistication. But of course, you know, all things be done in you know, decently and in order. There's no question about it. I'm not talking about free for all, swinging off the chandeliers and climbing walls and all that. I'm not talking about that. But the shout that you have here will carry you home. The shout that you have here with your brothers and sisters will be there Monday morning when you have to get up and go to work. It'll be there during the week that you get here on Wednesday for those of you who come. For those of you who can't come on Wednesday night, it'll carry you all the way till next Sunday. the shout, the blessing, the crying out and singing, praise God. Great is the Holy One of Israel in the midst of thee. Why do we cry out and shout? Because the one, the Holy One of Israel in our midst. How many are glad that God is here today?
Amen.
How many believe that God is here?
Yes.
Pastor Joseph, good to see you this morning.
Yes.
I was blessed when I saw you come down. But if you believe God is here, you have something to shout about.
That's right. Yes.
If you believe God is here, you have something to sing about.
Yes.
You have something to shout about. You have something to say.
Yes.
God is here. Look at your name and tell them, God's here, you know.
God's here.
Verse 7. Let's do it quick. Come on.
There is no 7.
Come on, Belec. We got to get through this.
There is no 7, brother.
There is no 7.
Is that the end of it?
Yes.
Well, I was ready to preach on. Let me write my own verse 7. Bless you. Cry out and shout, thou inhabitants of wrath.
Yes.
So what did we see here today? He prophesied that he was going to come. Jesus said, we got to hurry this and not wait. We got to bring it up here. And that happened 2,000 years ago when the angels began to announce joy to the world.
Yes.
There's that joy again. And on Christmas, we say, joy to the world. The Lord has come. Well, peace and goodwill to all men. Joy to the world. Everything about God spells joy. And some preacher about 50 years ago put it this way also, in your prayer time to give you real joy, J for Jesus first, O for others, then you, Y for you later, the last. Okay, well, J, O, Y, Jesus, others, then you. That's a good pattern to work with. That'll give you great joy. Jesus first, others, then you last. That's the way it happens. All right, we don't have no more scripture up there. I'm almost going pretty long. So what are we saying here today? You shall drop them. So let's put together. Jesus, the Apostle Peter wrote in his first chapter there. He said, "You have, though you haven't seen him, you have not known physically, yet you love him."
Yes, hallelujah.
Now, what's he saying? What is he saying? You don't see him now. You've not seen him. I've seen him. We were there, the next few verses there. He explains to them, we were there. We witnessed his sufferings. We witnessed his crucifixion. We've witnessed his resurrection. And so we witness it, but you have not. But don't worry. Someday you will see him.
Amen.
I've seen him. I've witnessed his suffering and resurrection. You've not seen him, and you love him more than I did when I saw him.
Amen.
Is that true? Yeah. You people who are suffering, all through the provinces where this letter was sent out to all the Messianic Jews, that were, you know, the Christian Jews that became Christians. He was right above them. You never saw him, but I saw him. And even having seen him physically, I still denied him 3 times one night.
Yes.
Ashamed. He said, your love for Christ puts me to shame. I knew him personally, and I denied him 3 times in one night because I had lack of character. Your rejoicing and your love for Jesus will not be unrewarded, because this same Jesus, the angel said, who you're seeing disappear now and going to the heavens, will in like manner return. Hallelujah. With a shout of the archangel, the sound of the voice of the archangel, the shout of the Lord, and with the sound of the trumpet, he will return on that cloud once again. He said, don't worry, keep loving him, keep believing in him, and keep rejoicing in him, because you are going to see him in a way that I never got to see him. Maybe I saw him physically, but you can see him in your spirit, in your heart, and you're going to see him face to face. And one day, John said, you're going to be just like him, for you shall see him face to face.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. So even now, no wonder it's a joy unspeakable, that is inexpressible, unfathomable, inexhaustible, because you're trying to describe the joy of heaven. Oh, with joy from the world. Listen, just to put it in John chapter 7, let me see if I can get John chapter 7, I told you I wouldn't double up here. John chapter 7, verse 35, 34. Let me see if I got it right. John chapter 7, verse 34, 35, somewhere in that area. Let's see if I get it right. 34, try 34. Try 36. I'll get you there. 37. Oh, there it is. Not bad for an old man. I knew I was in the ballpark.
Yes, you did.
You shall, with joy you shall draw from the wells of salvation. Guess where that well is. Jesus said this. In the last day, that great day of the feast, Jesus stood and cried, saying, if any man thirst, let him come unto me and drink.
Amen.
This is what Isaiah was saying that day. That was that day.
Is this day?
Since 2,000 years, that day has been this day for 2,000 years. And as long as the church is here, it's going to be that day.
Amen.
Verse 38, I guess. And he that believeth on me, as the scripture has said, out of his belly shall flow rivers of living water.
Yes.
See, if your well is dry, time for you to connect the hose, honey. Turn the faucet on. Because your soul needs to be saturated with this living. Jesus said, come unto me if you're thirsty and drink. Do you know when you come, I'm going to close with this. When you come to the church, when you come to the house of the Lord, pastors, listen closely. You need to refine the mannerism and the way to drink in the Spirit. To drink of the water. To drink of the presence. You need to fine-tune it. Some of you simply get the splash. You might have a little bit of splash, a spot of water on your lip even, and you say, that feels good. That's nice. But the way to drink of the Spirit is to allow yourself to be lost in the Spirit. Get into the spirit of worship. And just, hallelujah, Jesus, I love you. Hallelujah. Breathing in the breath of God in your worship unto Him. Diane, come here, quick. You're not here yet. You're not here yet. Come here, quick, quick. Come here, quick, quick, quick. How many heard this song before? Come here, baby. You're going to dance with me now. You're going to dance with me now. You know what song? Lost in the 50s tonight. How many has ever felt, you know, you dance with your wife? You get lost. And you don't ever want to be found.
Amen.
Just dance. You heard that song, Lost in the 50s tonight. Mm-hmm. We won't boogie here in front of you. But thank you, baby. Yeah. Lost in the 50s tonight. You know what it means. You know what this expression is, lost in the spirit of the moment?
Yes.
Enraptured in the moment. Captivated by the moment. That's how you drink in the Spirit. Get lost in the spirit of worship. And behold Him who sits on His throne. See Him as He is. And drink from the satisfaction of who Jesus is. Enjoy Him. Like I enjoy Diane and dance with her. Oh, the pastor dances. God have mercy. Don't fire me as your pastor. You just found me how I dance. I ought to be ashamed of myself. But I'm going to dance till I'm blue in the face. If I die with a heart attack dancing with the great pleasure of my wife, I will die a very pleasurable and enviable death. Thank you very much. Get lost in your dance with Jesus.
Yes.
When you're worshiping Him, you're dancing with Him. Mm-hmm. When you're worshiping Him, you're speaking good things of Him. And you can close your eyes and get lost in the spirit of worship. The Bible says that Father is looking for those who would worship Him in spirit and in truth. Get lost in the spirit of it all. And you know how you do, like you've been doing for the past 45 minutes, 50 minutes? You get lost in my message. You just get all just, it's all a good, nice mix, a good melange. You're just all in there. The same way when you worship God. So get rid of your religious, traditional backgrounds and get lost in Jesus today. Let's pray. I got to pray. Amen. I love y'all so very much. And I want you to taste what I taste, to see what I see. I want you to feel what I feel. I want you to experience what I experience every day. Father, we love you. We praise your name. We thank you for your faithfulness, your goodness toward us. Oh, Father, after this message today, I'm so excited about God and the things of God. We thank you, Lord, for your mercy. We thank you, Lord, for your faithfulness. We thank you, Lord, that today we can come before your presence and begin to experience that awesome experience, that experience of drinking from the wells of salvation with joy. Serving the Lord and worshiping the Lord is not a dredge. It is not burdensome. It's not loathsome. It's joy unspeakable, full of glory. Father, there may be one here today or two or more, or those watching by internet, those listening by CD, Father, that need to come to the well. Jesus said to the woman at the well, if you drink of this natural water, you'll thirst again. If you'll drink of the water that I give you, you'll thirst no more. If there's somebody here, Father, that is longing, who may be spiritually dry, like parched ground, and who is thirsty for the good things of God, I pray, God, in the name of Jesus today, may they respond to the Lord and His grace now in the name of Jesus and say, Pastor, I want this water. If you want my prayer, you want me to include you in a closing prayer of this message today, that God would drench your soul in His presence and embrace you now. If you need that refreshing of the Holy Spirit to draw from the wells of salvation with joy, raise your hand right now. God bless you. And be proud to be a Christian and be saturated in your heart and in your spirit. Father, for these precious souls that have raised their hearts to you, Lord, help us to see you. As we mentioned earlier in the message, Lord, to know you is to love you. And to love you is to draw from you, from the wells of salvation. You are our well. And the more that we get closer and closer to you, the wonderful embrace of God we can sense, it saturates our soul and our being. Our body even feels the effects of our soul being so blessed. Father, bless these. Raise them, O God, in this life. Raise them, Lord, in this experience with you. May they encounter Christ in a real way. May they see Him with their eyes closed even now, loving them, embracing them, granting them a grace beyond measure, a favor, so they can draw from the wells of salvation. They can draw, but they have to draw. We're not asking you, Lord, to turn the hose on and just sprinkle everybody. We're asking you, Lord, that these would draw. Reach out. For drawing, Lord, we have to reach out. We have to reach out and take it. Bless these, I pray, Father. Engulf them today with your holy presence. Bless them, Lord. Strengthen the weakest among us, Lord. May they receive a refreshing rain falling from heaven onto their souls. May they enjoy the blessed presence of Christ today. In the name of Jesus, we pray and ask these mercies with a joy everlasting upon their heads. In Jesus' name. Amen. Give the Lord another good clap offering. Let us stand together for the reading of the word. Hallelujah.